Hi guys! Welcome to Wanderlusting. I'm Runa.
And I'm Gaurav. And in today's video, we are going to share with you a 15-day itinerary of Greece. We'll try and share with you some information about your internal transfers by flights and ferries and some travel tips which can help you while you're traveling there. So without further ado, let's just jump into it.
Because Greece is the southernmost country of Europe. It has some amazing history, some of which actually dates back to 2000 to 3000 BC. It has almost 2000 islands, out of which 174 are inhabited. Some of the famous islands are Santorini, Mykonos, Naxos, and Milos. In this itinerary, we'll cover some of the very scenic natural wonders of Greece. It's actually impossible to cover Greece in 15 days, but we will still try to do our best.
The first thing that you need to plan out is whether you want to fly directly in and out of Athens or you want to fly directly to some islands. We suggest that you take your flight in and out of Athens. There are three reasons to it. One, Athens has got its own historical value. So you will enjoy your stay in Athens and get to see a lot of other places as well. Two, the connectivity of Athens is fairly good with other islands. So you can twist and tweak your itineraries depending on where you want to go. And the third is mostly the flights in and out of Athens to different countries is cheaper.
In Athens, you should stay very close to the central part of Athens. We stayed at a very good place called VP Homes. It's at Necklace Street. It has an amazing terrace where you can see Acropolis from. So it's amazing, guys. We'll share the link in the description box below. So the first day, you should just soak in the vibe of Athens. You should try some Greek food and also just explore some street food as well.
And one more tip. If you're staying at the center of this Athens, you can actually take a metro instead of taking up airport transfers by cab. While airport transfers can be really expensive, metro comes with just a 10 euro ticket. Day 2.
On this day, we'd like to visit all the famous sites like Acropolis, Panathenaeum Stadium and all. We suggest that have a good breakfast before you leave the room because there are many things to do on this day. So guys, we won't suggest you to go to Acropolis first because it's a huge rush in the morning hours. Instead, you can go and watch the change of guard at the Parliament House. So it happens every hour. So it happens at 9 a.m., 10 a.m. You can actually watch them just going and changing their duty and it's quite nice.
The second thing is that you should go to Mount Lycabettus. Now Lycabettus is the highest peak of Athens. If you want to hike it out, it's about 1000 steps. And if you're not in a mood to hike up so much, you can actually drive it to the parking lot. And from there, it's only about 200 steps. Summit of the Lycabettus kind of offers brilliant views of the city. There's also a chapel and a cafe in case you would like to care for some refreshments.
Before heading for the Acropolis, you can actually take a stop at Panathenaic Stadium. Guys, this is the stadium which was the home of the National Olympics, which started in 1896. It's made up of unique marble and it looks spectacular. It has a seating capacity of over 80,000 people. So you can stop there, click some great pictures and then head over to Acropolis.
Before you hike up to Acropolis, you can grab your lunch from a cafe at the base of Acropolis. Acropolis usually is slightly less crowded at the afternoon hours. It was actually built on a rocky cliff and is an amazing place. Has got some ancient buildings which are of great archaeological and historical significance. So be there, soak into the vibe of history and enjoy your evening there.
We suggest that you spend some 3 to 4 hours at Acropolis because anything less than that will not do justice to Acropolis.
Day 3.
So third day, guys, we recommend that you move out of Athens. Maybe you can take a direct flight to Crete. Crete is the biggest island of Greece and it's not as touristy and it's just spectacular. In Crete, you can either choose to fly to Heraklion or Hania. We thought of going to Hania first because we wanted to cover that part of Crete first.
So we are going to stay at Crete for 5 nights. I suggest you book at least 3 nights for Hania and 2 nights for Heraklion. Now, the best places to visit in Hania actually is the Old Town. And we suggest you to stay near the Old Town Harbor. We actually stayed at a place called Stephen City Hub, which was very close to the place. In the evening, you can actually go out and explore the Venetian Harbor.
Day 4 is the day when you should visit some of the beautiful beaches of Hania. We suggest first you should go and cover the Balos Beach. It's very beautiful, guys. You can rent a car actually from Old Town Hania. We got it from Safe Drive Cars, and the car was very nice, compact and easy to drive. So you can drive to Kassos and get a ferry to Balos Beach at 10:40 a.m. It's just one ferry per day, guys, so don't miss it. And it's a full day excursion. You will be back at 5 p.m. the same day, and you can again chill and relax at the Old Town.
Day 5. So today is the day when you need to visit the two beautiful beaches of Hania region. The first of them is Phalasarna. Phalasarna is about an hour's drive from Hania, and its golden sands and blue waters are sure to amaze you. It's one of the most beautiful beaches around the Hania region. From there you can actually drive to Elefanasi, which is also a beautiful beach, and it's actually known for its pink sand near the waters. From Elefanasi, you can view the sunsets also. Day 6.
On day 6, you should check out from Hania and proceed to Iraklion. On the way to Iraklion, you can also visit Rhythmino, which is a small town at the northern coastline of Crete. While you are there, you should visit the Forteza Fortress. It's built in the 16th century by Venetians, and when you explore fortress, you can see the entire view of the Rhythmino town.
On your way down from the Forteza Fort, you can actually go and visit this cafe called Thella's Grafia Cafe. You can have your lunch there. It's got amazing food, guys, with an amazing view. Once you're done with the lunch, start your journey again to Iraklion. It'll take about an hour for you to reach Iraklion from there, and you should try and stay near the Iraklion Fort. Iraklion Fort is one of the most beautiful forts that we have ever seen. Try taking a stroll in the evening there. We have seen one of the most stunning sunsets in Crete from the Iraklion port. Day 7.
On day 7, you should also visit some of the archaeological sites. In Iraklion, you have two famous archaeological sites. You have Kassos and Phaistos. While Kassos is more touristy and famous, we chose to visit Phaistos. It's more old than Kassos, and it's very, very beautiful, guys. It's one of its kind. So you can spend some good time there, you can have your Greek lunch at some of the taverna, and from there you can go to some of the beaches. So we visited Matala Beach, and it was very nice.
Matala Beach is actually only about 30 minutes drive from Phaistos, and it's well known for its blue waters, pebble sand and cave-like structures in the hills surrounding there. In the evening, you can spend your time in the market area near the Iraklion port.
Day 8. So today is the time to visit Santorini. You can return your car at Iraklion and book a ferry to Santorini. We recommend that you book your ferry in advance, and we highly recommend Golden Star ferries for that. It takes around 3 to 4 hours from Iraklion port to reach the Santorini or Thira port. From Thira port, you should book a ATV or a car. While in Santorini, you can choose to stay in Ia, Improvili or Fira. While Fira is little more touristy and is mostly a market, we chose Improvili and Ia. So the first 2 days we stayed at Improvili, and last 3 days we stayed in Ia.
So we stayed at this place called Unique Suites in Improvili. It's beautiful, guys, and it's got some stunning views of the caldera. They also have a jacuzzi and a sitting area outside the suite. Do whatever, but do not miss out your sunsets at Improvili. Day 9.
So this day you should explore Improvili more and more. You can have a breakfast and go first to the Anastasi Church. It's a famous place for Instagrammers. You can click some amazing pictures, guys. From there you can also go to visit the Scaros Rock. It's again a very famous place, guys. And then you should head to Fira to explore some marketplace, have some amazing Greek street food and relax and soak in the beauty of Fira.
Day 10. So this is today is the day when you should check out from Improvili and head to Ia. On the way, you can cover the three bells of Thira, as well as have some coffee at the Mama Thira Taverna. Once you reach Ia in the afternoon, you can chill at your Airbnb or the hotel that you have booked in. We actually stayed in one of the places which is called Inalion White Suites. It's actually at the center of Ia. A little difficult to find, but it offers one of the most beautiful views of Ia.
You should spend the evening watching the sunset either from the castle or the windmill. We suggest you go to the windmills because it's less crowded.
Day 11.
So today you can explore Ia more and more. You can visit the churches, some souvenir shops or cafes. From the souvenir shops you can actually buy some local handicrafts which are just beautiful, guys. You can also go to the three blue dome churches of Ia. It is the most Instagrammable places in Ia, where you can just click some beautiful picture, guys. From there you can go and have some lunch at maybe the Lotza cafe. It's very famous.
Once you're done with your lunch, you can head to Amodi Bay. It can be reached by a hike from the Ia castle, or you can drive down also. It's about 10-15 minutes. But it's really, really scenic, guys. You can actually enjoy the sunset from there. There are many eateries from which you can have seafood. Day 12. After your breakfast, you can head to this place called Pygros. Pygros is actually about a 30 to 40 minute drive from Ia. It was essentially the former capital of Santorini. It has got the Pygros castle, which is one of the best places to visit. It has got a special vibe to it, and trust me guys, it's not touristy at all.
If you have time in the day left, you can explore the Santorini vineyards and you can also go to the Pyrrha market.
Day 13.
So check out from your Ia hotel and go to Milos. So you have to book a ferry in advance because there are very few ferries in and out of Milos. So once you reach Milos, you will at once notice the calm and quietness the city has to offer. Most of the places in Milos can be covered by boat, and it has a real beautiful vibe to it, guys.
We actually stayed at a place called Hotel Milos, which is only about 5 minutes from the Adamas port of Milos. After a smooth check-in, you can come out at the port area of Adamas and explore the area in and around. Milos is actually known for its full-day excursions. We decided to go with Horizon Yachts as they are super friendly and economical too. After exploring port for some time, you can have your dinner at one of the restaurants at the Adamas port and sleep tight. Day 14.
Today is the excursion day, guys. So you should leave your hotel by 9:30 after the lunch and reach the port by 10. The cruises generally starts around 10. They will take you to some 3-4 famous places and offer food and drink on board. Mostly all the cruises do that. So among all the four places, the two most famous places are Sikya Caves and Cleftico. First, they will take you to the Sikya Caves, which is just mind-blowing. They'll stop there for some time, around 30 minutes. You can have something, have your drink, swim around and come back to the boat. From there you will go to the final destination, which is Cleftico, and it's out of the world. So you can snorkel, you can spend some good amount of time clicking pictures and have your lunch there, and then you just relax on the boat and come back to the port around 5 p.m.
By evening you can actually catch a cab to the Plaka city. Plaka is actually the capital of Milos. From there, you can explore the narrow lanes of Plaka, and then you can see the sunsets from either the Plaka castle or the main church. Have your dinner and then head back to your hotel.
Day 15. So last day has to be the best. So today you can visit the most famous beach, which is Sarakiniko. It's out of the world, guys. It has moon-like rocks, it's all white in color, and the sea is just blue. You can swim around, click pictures, and just spend some quality time at the most famous Sarakiniko beach. You will love it, guys. Come back to your hotel and relax and catch a flight to Athens the next day.
So that is about a 15-day itinerary, guys, and we hope you liked it. If you like the video, please give it a big fat thumbs up. This is Runa and Gaurav signing off from Wanderlusting. Keep traveling, keep exploring.
Until we meet again.
Bye-bye.